God, from the beginning of time, loved us and planned to redeem us. Once he found that people were not capable of living with his gift of free will and loving him and each other, the highest king chose to come to the lowest place. He came down to earth in the most humble way and showed us through his unconditional love how we should love one another and worship him.
Thank you.
rebellious children, God's people were not living as he wanted them to live. Like a loving but frustrated parent, God tried many ways to turn them around. In a fashion, he spanked them and tried timeouts. He even sent wise mentors, but yet they continued to turn from him. Despite people's hate and indifference, God, whose mercy was in motion from the beginning of time, came down himself and brought the greatest gift of all, eternal life. Let the earth receive her king.
Reveals himself to earth.
out of the pain of the people of Israel came the predictions by prophets of a coming Savior. These faithful men recorded God's words that told of a king whom he would send to his people, a redeemer who would save God's people from their sins and bring us, everlasting hope.
Counselor, Prince of Peace.
One night, the angel Gabriel appeared to Mary and said, "Greetings, favored woman. The Lord is with you. The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the baby born to you will be holy, and he will be called the Son of God." Thus, the great prophecies of Isaiah, Micah, Nathan, Jacob, and the promise of God to Eve in the Garden of Eden came to pass. Our Savior, Jesus Christ, the blessed hope of Israel, was born into the world.
Thank you.
It was a moment like none other in heaven. One night in history, one instant in time, God the Son, who existed always and forever in perfect unity with God the Father, stepped out of heaven onto the earth below. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. So Joseph went up from the town of Nazareth to Bethlehem, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in strips of cloth and placed him in a manger because there was no room in the inn. God's perfect and mysterious plan of grace had begun to unfold. On the earth, only a few knew of this miraculous event. Shepherds who worked in the open fields and wise men who traveled from the far east, they were the first to discover God's greatest gift. Our Savior had finally found us.
Ooh.
when Jesus was born, an angel appeared to the shepherds, and the radiance of the Lord's glory surrounded them. I bring you good news of great joy for everyone. The Savior, yes, the Messiah, the Lord, has been born tonight in Bethlehem, the city of David. Suddenly, the angel was joined by a vast host of others, the armies of heaven praising God. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace, goodwill to whom all God favors. Kings of the Old Testament began their reigns gloriously and triumphantly. Therefore, the people of Israel were expecting the Messiah to come into the world amid trumpet fanfare and cheering crowds. Split the sky with royal splendor to save them like the people expected. Instead, he appeared in lowly birth. was found in the meekest and lowliest of places, a barn, with animals as his witnesses, not a room that should have been rich with the sweet smell of incense, one filled with the beauty, the glorious light, and adoring throngs of people. Instead of a beautiful golden throne, he lay in a cattle stall, born of common parents, in a small, common village. reaction of all who came to the manger that first Christmas night. The silent worship of Mary and Joseph was broken by the arrival of the shepherds, who told of an angel appearing to them with glorious news. After they beheld their king, they left to the glorifying and praising God for what they had seen and heard. After a time passed, the wise men from the east arrived and told of following a star that was leading them to the King of the Jews. We can only imagine and wonder at the reverence that rose in the hearts of Mary and Joseph as they witnessed these magi in all their pomp and finest, kneeling on the ground, bowing to a child.
See me. Keep on heaven
holiday season, may we stand in wonder of the one who came pursuing us. May we worship him who did not come into this world with pomp and circumstance, in flowing robes, seating himself on a golden throne. May we worship him with great joy and celebration. He who was born of a lowly virgin in a lowly place on a quiet night. God did not make us come to him, but rather the Holy One humbled himself and came to us.